Alright girls, let's be real. Finding the right hair products is like winning a lottery. It's rare but so real. Today I'm gonna talk about Indian curly hair products that made my hair thrive and well some that didn't work. Stick around because I'm also gonna talk about affordable alternatives for products that failed me and also what you should look into while buying products for your curls. So let's get started. Growing up with waves and curls, I really didn't know what to do of it, you know. So I gave in to the pressure and I really wanted my hair to look very shiny and straight. So I tried, you know, straightening, doing keratin, blow drying, and that damaged my curls further. And then I came to a realization that, you know what, I need to embrace my curls. And then, you know, I watched a lot of online reviews, videos, and you know, I tried and tested so many products. I learned and unlearned a lot of things, and today I'm going to give you an honest lowdown so that you don't have to waste your time and money. So first, let's talk about products that worked for my hair type. The first one is curl up products. So the curl up shampoo, conditioner and the curl defining cream, all three did wonders to my curls. Like, it's very lightweight, so it works for my hair type because my hair is like, you know, it has low porosity, so anything which is very heavy, it makes my hair super greasy, super oily. And then, you know, my roots here, it looks very flat, you know, so it does not give you that volume and definition. But I think amongst the three products, my favorite is the shampoo and conditioner. The shampoo has that coconutty mild fragrance and it makes my hair smell good and my hair feels very soft and very smooth. And even the conditioner is good, but the curl defining cream, at least for people with my hair type, just use a very coin sized amount. I've also made a separate video about that, so I'm linking it down in the description. Feel free to check it out. Next product that worked on my hair type is Arata styling gel. Now see, I'm not a big fan of gels, okay? Like, I always prefer leave-in conditioner and then a bit of curl defining cream, but I just thought, let me try some gel. Like, let me see how it works on my hair. And I tried it and trust me, it gave my curls such good definition. Like, if you can see my hair, like, this is my hair now, okay? It is straight and then wavy and then there are these loose curls, okay? But when I tried that gel along with the leave-in conditioner, it gave my curls good definition even in this humid weather. And it has flax seeds, you know, and flax seeds, like, I've tried flax seeds, I've soaked it in water earlier and I've tried that gel on my hair, so I had that trust that, okay, if any product has flax seeds, it'll definitely be good. So it had that shine, it gave me that smooth, long-lasting effect. In fact, I think on my second day, my friend was like, why are your curls looking so like bouncy, did you do something, did you style your hair? And I'm like, no, these are just natural curls, you know. So that worked, but I don't use curling gels that often unless I'm going out for some event or something like that, because I don't have that kind of time. But yeah, this definitely worked for me. Next is my personal favorite, L'Oreal Paris leave-in conditioner. Leave-in conditioner is a must for all the curly hair girlies. Do not think that, you know, oh, okay, you know what, I don't want to use a lot of products on my hair. It's okay, it's completely fine. Like, you can skip gel, mousse and other things, but leave-in conditioner, never skip that. And for me, L'Oreal Paris leave-in conditioner, it does the work for me, you know. It moisturizes my hair, it keeps my hair frizz-free. Now see, if you have curly hair, having frizz, it's inevitable, okay? You can't like completely you know, get rid of it, but you can definitely use products that minimizes it. And for me, this does wonders. If you all have seen my earlier hair care routine videos, L'Oreal Paris leave-in conditioner, it has been one constant product in all of my videos. So that is like my personal favorite. I like, now also, if I'm in a rush, I have to go somewhere, I'll just wash my hair with shampoo and conditioner and then I'll just use some of the leave-in conditioner, run it through my hair and that's it, I'm done. And then later on, once it's dry, I will use some you know, lightweight oil serum, that's it. That's all you need, okay? So like, this is like Chummeshwari for me. Next is the Vilva goat milk shampoo. As I told you all, like, for my hair type, I always prefer a shampoo which is very mild with good fragrance, which makes my hair smell great. And Vilva goat shampoo is the second one, my second favorite. First was curl up's coconut based mild shampoo slash cleanser, and then there is this one, because this cleans my scalp, okay? So dandruff and all that things, my hair, then it's less prone to dandruff. And yeah, like, it, my hair smells good and my hair feels soft and smooth. It's a very mild, gentle cleanser slash shampoo. Why am I stammering? Cleanser slash shampoo. So you can try this if you're looking for a mild cleanser which is not very heavy on your hair and your scalp. Also, before I move towards products that did not work for my hair, I wanted to know, have y'all tried any of these products that I mentioned earlier, or do you have any of your personal favorite that you think I should try? So let me know in the comments. I would love to hear your recommendation. Now we are going to talk about products that did not work for my hair type. The first one is Wow Skin Science Apple Cider Vinegar Shampoo. Now see, this product is very popular. You know, you can see ads on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, and even on Amazon. Okay, so I thought, let me give it a try, because you know, there were so many good reviews about this product, and I thought, let me see if it works for my hair type. It did not, you know. It made my hair, you know, very stripped and dry, and although it did clean my scalp, like my scalp felt cleaner, and you know, there was no dandruff and all on my scalp. So that, obviously, that's a good thing. I think a shampoo should definitely clean out your scalp and everything. But my curls, it felt very dry, and you know, it was not, I didn't get that moisturized, very shiny, bouncy feeling with that product. And I think it's better suited for people who have straight/wavy or very silky straight hair. And if you are someone who has, like, you know, this kind of curls like mine, or you know, very coiled curls and tighter curls, I don't think so, you should try this product. Next product that did not work for my hair type is Mama Earth Onion Hair Mask. I had high hopes from this product because of the rave reviews online, but when I tried this, it weighed my hair down, it made my hair super greasy, the volume kind of shrunk, you know, and my hair felt very oily, and it didn't look like this, you know. But my friend, she has like a tighter pattern and very coiled kind of curls. It worked like wonders on her hair. So I think, again, it's because of the hair type. So people with my kind of hair type, it's a no-no. But people who have like tighter patterns, you can definitely try this product. Next on the list is TRESemmé Keratin Smooth Hair Conditioner. I used this product when I just started my curly hair journey, and that time I think there was this big hype about keratin treatment, keratin shampoos, etc, etc. So I thought, let me try using it. At least if it makes my hair more smooth and silky, and I think all curly hair girlies can relate to it. We want nothing but our hair, you know, to be more frizz free, more smooth, silky, shiny. So that was my goal when I considered this product, and yes, it did make my hair more soft, smooth, silky, and my curls looked good, but it did cause a lot of, you know, scalp buildup. And to ensure I get rid of it, I used a mild scalp cleansing shampoo. But you know, in the long run, this product just didn't work for me. It made my hair look good, but my scalp health was messed up. So yeah, I stopped using it. But yeah, if it works for you, then great, but it didn't work for me. The last one on the list is Induleka Bhringa Oil. Now this oil, it was like, you know, there was this hype about this oil, so I decided to try it, and it is definitely good for scalp health, okay, like baby hairs, and you know, to reduce hair fall and everything. But it is not curly friendly because it is so thick, the consistency is so thick that you have to like wash your hair using like a lot of shampoo, like you have to like legit wash your hair like that, and then that will make your hair super dry, and still there will be some residue left on your scalp, and that will again cause a lot of buildup. One solution for this would be to use a clarifying, you know, cleansing shampoo. But even after that, like I tried that, it still did not get rid of the buildup. So I still felt like my scalp was very oily, very chip-chippa and everything. I think this works great on straight and wavy hair, but not curly hair friendly. I think that's the thing with a lot of products, you know, many are not curly friendly. Now lately, I think things are evolving, and then there are a lot of products which are meant for both straight and curly hair. But earlier, I think it was not. Sad. I feel hair care is so personal, you know, like the whole journey, it's very personal, because what can work for my hair type or for me, it may not work for you, and vice versa. So let me know in the comments if you have tried any of these products that I mentioned, and yes, let's chat and help each other out. And that's the list of Indian curly products that worked and did not work for my hair. Remember, curly hair journey is unique, okay, and it's all about experimenting, doing a lot of trial and errors, and finding what works the best for your curls. And yes, yes, that was about it for today's video. I hope you all learned and enjoyed a lot of things in this video, and if you all did, you all know what to do: like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel. And if you are not following me on Instagram, why are you not following me on Instagram? Please do follow me on Instagram. I post a lot of acting skits, real talk rants, and I'm 1000% sure you guys are going to enjoy it, and I've linked my account in the description, so please do hit a follow. And yes, until next time, keep learning and loving your curls. Bye-bye.